A well-intentioned, wholesome slice-of-life drama, Disney Plus Hotstar's Ghar Waapsi is a story we've seen before. But does it manage to go beyond hollow, feel-good warmth alone? The middle-class comedy drama series, a space dominated by TVF, tends to come in two varieties. The sincere, specific story which has something to say, and those which feel like harmless, generic assembly line products of nostalgia-fueled small-town charms, which are big on feeling but low on substance. Recent shows like Home Shanti and Saas Bahu Achar come to mind. Undeniably sweet, but little else. Despite its rough edges, thankfully, Ghar Waapsi belongs to the former. While its destination might be a tad too simplistic and convenient, there's a lot to be said for the journey. Created by Dice Media, the production house behind some of my favorite shows, like Little Things, What the Folks, and Not Fit, Ghar Waapsi follows Shekhar, played by an impressive Vishal Vashishtha, who works within Bangalore's great Indian startup circus. Shekhar's entire life is the grind. Conference calls, presentations, post-work drinks, a faint sense of a social life, EMIs, and car loans. But when Shekhar is suddenly laid off, he's forced to return home to his family in Indore to take stock, reevaluate the rat race, and do some much-needed soul-searching. And of course, back home, he's met with old wounds that need healing as he's forced to reconnect with his past and the people he left behind.
Two nithalle kam the is ghar mein, teesra bhi wapas aa gaya. Sabke samne mein naak katwa diya.
Directed by Ruchir Arun and written by Tatsat Pandey and Bharat Mishra, Ghar Waapsi is far from original. Hollywood has even made an entire subgenre of the soul-searching moving back home movie, with films like This Is Where I Leave You, New in Town, Standing Up, Falling Down, Sweet Home Alabama, and even the Hannah Montana movie. Yeah, that's right, I just referenced the Hannah Montana movie, so what? Closer to home, it's a theme that's been explored multiple times in Dice Media's own Little Things, a lot of which was also directed by Ruchir Arun. We see it in the excellent first episode of the second season in which Dhruv's school friend visits him in Mumbai after years, and the two end up clashing. Dhruv's old worldview and identity being at odds with his new one. More specifically, we see it at the end of season 3 where Kavya chooses to do just this, move back home to Nagpur as a result of missing her family and the simple pleasures of home. But Ghar Waapsi explores these ideas in more depth and detail across a 6-episode series. It's a thoughtful, sensitive show that I found myself getting increasingly lost in. In Shekhar's struggles of being caught up between his two worlds, the freedom, acceptance, and energy of life in the big city versus the familiar comforts and conservative trappings of small-town life. The warmth and ease of the people and life that was versus the excitement and exhaustion of independence. The conflict of returning home to realize both how much you're missing and why you left in the first place. The place may be the same, the people unchanged, but it's you that's different. Sometimes going back is the only way to move forward. And perhaps the past you thought you outgrew is now the very future that you aspire to.
Change kiya hai inhone kafi kuch.
Ab aap do saal baad aoge, par cheeze to badal jayenge na bhaiya.
It's a struggle beautifully expressed in one scene in Amazon Prime Video's recent Sudal, where two characters discuss why one of them chose to leave their hometown while the other chose to stay. For one, the small town is suffocation and feeling caged by the people she knows all too well. For the other, it's that very same familiarity that he takes comfort in. As we watch Shekhar reconnect and rediscover his family and friends, we too feel for them and fall for them. Be it Vibha Chibber as Shekhar's overbearing mother, or an extremely huggable Atul Srivastava as Shekhar's peacekeeping father, or his siblings played by Saad Bilgrami and Anushka Kaushik. The endearing Ajitesh Gupta as Shekhar's loyal to a fault best friend Darshan in particular hit home. There's also the character of Shekhar's college senior Manish Bhaiya, who's essentially just an uplifting TED talk with legs. Think Kota Factory's Jitu Bhaiya if he retired and opened a cafe. Not to mention Shekhar's old flame who he bumps into, Ridhima, played by the endlessly charming Akanksha Thakur. And of course, sparks fly once again.
Shekhar Dwivedi, what are you doing in Indore?
Why is it that in all the shows and movies like this, the main character always seems to find love when they move back home? The rest of us are out here, can't even find a freaking working plug point at a cafe, and my man is out here finding love? Screw you. Despite its forgiving 6-episode length, Ghar Waapsi also doesn't always earn its 40-minute-plus episode runtime, with long stretches halfway through the series where I just kept wishing the writing was tighter and more focused. And as you'd expect, in keeping with its feel-good tonality, by the last episode, all the key conflicts are neatly resolved. A dysfunctional family fairy tale where distances are mended, old wounds are healed, and solutions arise just when we need them to. But these are still conveniences that feel oddly earned in an optimistic, hopeful story that argues that maybe there is hope for the big Indian family yet. There are also times where the writing doesn't speak through the characters as much as it does talk at us. particularly in the shaky last episode where a character giving a business presentation at work doubles as a contrived voiceover about life. And similarly, later in that very episode, Shekhar finally crumbles under the pressures of corporate life, resulting in a long Pyar Ka Panch Nama TVF AIB sketch style monologue that feels like it was specifically engineered for virality on social media. But at its best, Ghar Waapsi is a quarter life crisis show which captures a moment in time. To the extent where I'd argue it's near impossible not to relate to some aspect of Shekhar's life and reflect on your own. It's a show that I can see myself coming back to someday and maybe getting something different from. Gentle life lessons in the form of a story for when life's got you down or for when you miss home. A narrative engineered to tell you that it's all going to be okay. A gentle series centered on a simple yet important idea. That when you're so preoccupied with the rat race of life, you run the risk of rushing past and leaving behind the people that matter most. Would I recommend Ghar Waapsi to a friend? With a hug and a smile, absolutely.